invite you to join us in our opening hymn found on the PowerPoint. Your servant Marion, whom we perform the paternal offices of bearer,
a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness of you, so that on the day of resurrection, free from the bonds of mortality, she may face you face to face. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us be seated, my friends, as we listen to God's holy word. I'd like to invite Kathleen forward to share with us.
The souls of the righteous are in the hands of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and their departure was thought to be a disaster. And they are going from us to be their destruction, but they are in peace. For though in the sights of others they are punished, and their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself, like gold in the furnace. He tried them like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his holy ones as he watches over his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Beggars, right after the beer store, and so forth. response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In baptism, Mary received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister Marion, who ate the body of Christ, bring her life, that she may be raised up to share in the glory of Christ. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Consoled by the promise of immortality. Indeed, for your faithful people, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of their glories without end, we acclaim. Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks and praise, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Of our Lord be with you all.
and with your spirit.
Let us share with each other a sign of peace.
Prayers rise to God.
assure and certain that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness. Merciful Lord, turn toward us. Listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise, dear servant, and help us to remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet Christ and are with you and with our sister Marion forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. We'll have lunch in there, and we have a few words, I believe, and offer some words of remembrance for Marion. We'll also say a blessing at this time. Let's pray right now, just to bow our heads. Pray the Lord's blessing of grace, so that when we get into the hall, we'll be able to enjoy the food. Lord our God, we thank you for that feast in heaven that awaits us. We ask you to bless this food which we're about to receive this day. Until that day, you come to call each of us to be home forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So when you get into the hall, just go right into the coffee line, the food line, and drink food. Tom, on the way out of Mass on Sunday, his father, who says, Mom always liked a good joke at the end of Mass. Would you tell her? I said, well, I'd be wrong. I guess I'll twist my arm. I found one for Mary that I thought she would like. So it says, on the Sunday before Christmas, Reverend Billy Graham was walking down the street in Mount Holly, North Carolina, on the way to see a parishioner. However, he wanted to post a parcel urgently, so he asked the young boy where he could find the post office. When the boy had directed him, Billy Graham thanked him and said, if you come to church tonight, you can hear me telling everyone how to get to heaven. The boy replied, I think I'll skip. If you don't even know your way to the post office, how do you lead me to heaven? Oh, Mary, let us stand, my friends, as we ask for God's final blessing. Dear friends in Christ, may every affection, every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest. Amen. Please join in our closing.